Supernatural Podcast is back from much demand. I speak English good.
Two people said,
Two
where is
people
it?
said, "Where is it?" We had a sort of a break. It was just sort of like we just didn't feel like watching Supernatural, honestly. And like that, it always sucks if you're like trying to like record something and you're really not feeling it. So we just figured we'd have a few episodes and condense them
Figured
together.
we'd wait and not feel like it later.
And not feel like it later. I felt more like it now. It's still Supernatural is what it is, but I feel better about condensing them a little bit rather than just trying to stretch it if I'm
Yeah,
not
I
feeling
think
it.
this will be better doing these three together than separate.
Yeah, I feel like each of the episodes have something to say about it. I was worried it was going to be kind of samey, which any of the plot overarching arc overarching story plots seem to kind of blend
Overarching
together.
arc.
Overarching arc. I speak good. all of the stuff for like the overarching story of the season kind of blends together, but we had a little variation with these, so
No.
nope. So the first one we watched was The Bad Seed. And before we get into the plot of that, did we talk about the last time the stupid CGI baby face effect?
Oh no, you said we didn't.
No, I asked if we did, but then I never got an answer because I guess you don't remember either. But anyway, if we didn't talk about it, I feel it's noteworthy because it was awful. Like that was like Twilight levels of like creepy baby aging face CGI. Like that's
Was
bad.
pretty dumb looking.
It was dumb looking. Like, I mean, I guess on a technical level, they didn't do it wrong. It's just the idea entirely is stupid. Like, oh, let's see the face changing into an older face on a baby. No, thank you. So yeah, they talk about how the darkness is this all-powerful thing, but then why did it start as a baby? If like it can like super age itself, and that's why, because it's all-powerful, like why did it even start as a
Because it
baby at
needs
all?
to eat to grow to its final form.
That's stupid.
I like too that after she eats so much souls, she Pokeballs to the next Pokemon form. Like, it's not like she keeps getting older, like, every time she eats. It's just, oh, looks like she's evolving. Doo 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 doo.
Name that Pokemon! The darkness uses Soul Suck. It's super ineffective.
I'm glad we learned that despite her having to eat souls, a demon will work the same, apparently.
Yeah, I guess if
wouldn't
you
think
think of
that's the same thing, but all right.
Demons as like humans whose souls were turned into whatever in hell, I guess then it would be a sort of soul. I don't
Yeah,
know.
it seemed weird to me that that's the exact same thing and works, but.
Yeah, it was a little weird. I thought it was weird that okay, so the darkness Amara or whatever her name is, they're teaching her all about the world because she was older than the Earth before she was locked away or whatever. But then she knows English automatically, but not other
Yeah.
languages. They're
That
like, oh,
was
we have like
like,
hit.
after she evolved from baby, that was their first move. She learned. Amora has learned English attack.
Because
Doo
they're like, oh, we translated Hitler's speeches for her because, she wouldn't know German. It's like, well, yeah, but then she would know
doo.
English? Like, she'd be
Yeah, I
before
love
the.
that silliness.
She'd
Like,
be before her language
English
anyway.
is the language that's the oldest. Oh wait, no, it's not even slightly. But whatever.
That's what they
English is
primarily.
beyond time.
Well, it's because English is what they speak in hell, so I guess she had to learn the hell language.
The
I love fucking.
official language of hell. Shh. All right.
I think the theme of this episode was just when you think it couldn't get any lamer, it does. Crowley just spends the whole episode being her babysitter, giving her like
Yeah.
treats and pop-up
Oh.
books and shit.
And when you fucking saw the nanny, you knew immediately she was gonna get killed by the stupid demon kid.
Oh,
And
yeah.
then, like, who the fuck? Like, I imagine she was really proud before this, too. Like, I'm Hell's nanny.
No, I don't know anyone who'd be proud to be. That's like, what was your lot in life that you
Hell's
become the
nanny.
hell nanny?
I'm Hell's nanny.
Like, hell just keeps getting lamer and lamer in this show.
Stupid Crowley, too, is like, you know, Amora keeps going, I'm hangry. And then he brings out donuts or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, he has some snacks. And she's like, no, I wanted a soul, idiot. Oh, I forgot, even though I brought you souls before. Apparently, this is unforeseen by me that you would want to eat souls now.
Yeah, like, they're acting like, oh, he's weirded out. She's more evil than he could imagine. It's like, what? It's not even really that evil compared to anything he's done or they would do with the demons in hell. Like, it's just stupid.
Yeah.
He's bringing her, like, a dress and cupcakes and all that. And you're like, and he's telling her to watch her language. Just,
Well, he brought her a dress with blood on it because they can't get a dress without killing someone.
Well, they're evil, you see. So they had to kill someone.
I'm completely ineffectual at just going and getting a dress. So you have to kill it off of someone.
Well, where's the fun in that if you just go buy a dress?
Oh, no.
But souls, that crossed the line for him.
Well, efficiency is not Crowley's strong suit. As we see that he runs hell from that stupid basement on Earth still below that Italian restaurant.
We're trying to make the pizzas, Crowley. Quit with your babysitting the darkness. You need to get the pepperonis.
I always wondered if running hell from hell might make more sense, but then I was like, no, I can get people to tell other people what I said. I decreed it. Go down to hell and tell them I decreed it. I don't want to go down there. Why the hell would I want to go to hell?
You know what I absolutely loved in this episode? They had that scene where the two grunts, one from heaven, one from hell, just meet up, like, at a diner or something, and they just talk, like, hey, what's going on in your town, or in hell? What's going on in heaven? Oh, yeah, that's kind of a bummer.
Yeah, they just said how they suck. That was kind of the best part of the episode.
That was amazing. I thought maybe one of the grunts was the soul got sucked, but I couldn't tell if it was actually him or not. So it might have been that was the only scene with them, which was kind of amazing. Like, yeah. I kind of love that. Oh, they're like, oh, ever since Hannah died, heaven's been, what was it, a suck sandwich? I wrote it down in my notes. I put the suck sandwich one on there.
This is one of the nicest angels we've seen in a long time, is this one palling around with a demon so that
That's
they can
true.
Just pal, like, say how stupid everything is. You know, heaven and hell are both stupid. Yeah, let's drink.
But, like, I really want to know.
I just want a series about them watching this stuff happening. And like, wow, it's really stupid.
I really want to know, though, why heaven was better when Hannah was alive. Like, what she contributed. Why it made heaven a suck sandwich when she died. Miss Popcorn Bag. I just don't understand this.
I don't know. Who knows what she did. She did good things off screen, but we'll never know. Anyway, she's dead now, lol.
She's waiting in a car in heaven's heaven? I don't... Where do they go when they die?
Hannah's waiting in the car, which is where I will be. I will be watching The Wire.
Well, I'll get to that when we get to the other episodes, but that is stupid. But
don't jump ahead.
Yeah, don't jump ahead. Well, first we got to talk about the continuing. Just when you think it couldn't get lamer, it does. Rowena's back. And
we're
just
going to make the mega coven.
The mega coven.
She got the greatest witches, which she easily dispatches with a stupid spell.
Well, even like she tries to get these other group of witches, and they easily get killed by a demon too. So all of the best of the best that she
only
keeps...
one of them. But yeah.
Yeah, but they're just like easily disposed of. They show no ability whatsoever, which could be her just like, you know, blowing sugar up their asses just to get them to join. But then why does she want them anyway?
I just thought it was so stupid that she's able to do that. And like, so it, like at which like club or whenever they meet up, it's just like, you never know. Like one of them might just decide to go and blow you up. Like, and it's that easy. You can't protect yourself from that. It's just, well, I sure hope that one of them just doesn't decide to blow me up today, because all they need to do is yell a few words and wiggle their fingers. And of course, she can never do that to Sam or Dean, but I guess these super powerful witches, they suck. So it's easy to kill them with just...
The thing that kills...
Or you need sandwich bullets, because they're the only thing that can kill witches. Which is what Sam was his gun with, sandwich bullets. Your sandwich bullets, they'll kill you, Maria.
I love they just capture her to cure Castiel and then fuck off. Like, it's like just clearly just a plot device, not even really like an interesting point where it's like, ooh, they have Rowena, what's gonna happen? It was just sort of like, they just needed her to get that over with.
Yeah, what was the point of that ever? Nothing.
The thing that kills me with Rowena is, like, they keep trying to make her doofy, and they do that with Crowley, too, where they try to make it, like, it's funny, because the show is, like, kind of humorous, too, but they don't do it right. They do it in a way that's completely moronic and lame. Like, it's like, if you're gonna have a villain that's pathetic, but then, you know, sort of they can do some damage too. Like, they've done that on other shows before. Like, Buffy did it when they had the three nerds. They were really pathetic, and then they did some damage. They didn't expect that they could do it because they were so pathetic, and then all of a sudden, like, they actually did some real damage. You can do that with a character like that. If you're gonna make them pathetic, you don't make them really ancient and powerful already, and then all of a sudden they're not really that scary. Mm-hmm. Like, because she was Crowley's mom. That was a big deal, that it was Crowley's mom, and that she was killing people in this coven, and that, you know, she was this ancient witch that, you know, was from way back when, the mother of the King of Hell.
Any of that was done well.
No, it wasn't done well, but that's what they presented her as. But then all of a sudden, but she's just pathetic. So if you're going to have them pathetic, you got, like, it's got to be sort of like, maybe their power is kind of unexpected, or they're pathetic, but then they get the upper hand, and, you know, they use that to their advantage or something. But you can't just be like, this is this ancient evil, and by the way, they're super lame, and you don't care, and they never do any damage.
And she's like, I'm gonna have my mega coven meetings in a restaurant, because why not do that in a public area where people could hear, or apparently come to assassinate you.
That seemed kind of out of nowhere, the mega coven thing. Like, her saying something like that, like, that seemed weird, because she's always been pathetic, but she's never been like, oh, the mega coven, like, something like that. Like, it's always been sort of like, I don't know.
This is the first time we've seen her this season, so apparently they're trying to be more doofy with her.
Maybe, because she's always been really petty and useless. But never, like, just completely, like, lame like that, I guess, intentionally.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's just my guess of what they're trying to do with her this season.
Like, maybe they're trying to downplay her a bit because they're focusing on the darkness.
Because they're
going to
fucking put her into Crowley zone, where she's, like, sort of bad, but not too bad, and they'll still have her do bad things, but we'll keep her in that stupid zone where it's just annoying.
Her character's not helpful or interesting enough for that to work, though. Because Crowley, there were points where it did. It's run its course now.
But they keep doing this. They keep having Sam and Dean have to do these stupid little things with her. And that's what I'm thinking they're going to keep doing. It's like, oh, well, she's bad, but we got to do something with her again.
But she's not a compelling character to make that work, or they don't do any stories with that to make it interesting.
It's old with Crowley. I don't want to see it with another character. It's like, I want Crowley to be fucking one way or the other, not this middle ground bullshit.
Right, who the hell knows what he's doing right now? He's being a dad.
He's a bad dad, I guess.
So I guess that's about it for that episode. That's all I had written down anyway.
Sandwich bullets.
Sandwich bullets.
He says, like, these are bullets that'll kill a witch. I do want to know what the fuck that means. Like, why do you need special bullets for a witch? Apparently you can just run up and slit one's throat. That killed her fine in the restaurant, but you need sandwich bullets or you're going to shoot one. Whatever.
I don't know.
Doesn't make any sense. They're people, but they have powers. Like, they have magical powers.
I don't know. That could have been something that was explained back in the Ruby days or something. I don't know. It's not enough that I care to look it up. It's some bullshit. I just thought
it seemed silly. Anyway, car episode.
Yeah, it was silly. Yeah, the one after that was Baby, which was the car one. And that's actually the note I wrote was the car one.
They had to recap the car.
They had to recap the car. Why did they have to recap that for that? You don't need to recap it to understand the gimmick. It was, it's pretty clear. So what did you think of the episode?
It had some moments, I guess, but I don't know. It was definitely a bottle episode.
Oh, yeah. I actually kind of liked it. It wasn't like the greatest thing in the world, but it was compared to, you know, recent seasons. I actually liked it all right.
Sam at least got rid of a secret in this episode. So.
They got rid of a secret in the episode before that, too. Like, Rowena told Dean about Sam's deal.
Yeah.
And then in the car one, what was the secret that got told in that one about...
That he was infected.
That he was infected, yeah. So they got rid of a couple secrets. Still got the big one.
They
I love to,
young
like...
version dad, because they weren't getting, what's his name to do it again? Jeffrey Dean Morgan.
Yeah, Jeffrey Dean Morgan. I know he said before that he'd be happy to come back to the show, though, so I don't think it's, like, having to do with him not wanting to do it, but... It'd be nice to see him again. I like Jeffrey Dean Morgan, but I suppose if they were going to bring him back, it seems like you'd want something a little bigger and more important than just the
just,
car dream cameo.
Drive the car for a little bit.
Yeah.
Hey guys.
But the car gimmick I liked all right. Like, I thought it was an interesting way to go about it, and just what would otherwise be a fairly standard story.
Yeah,
it had some good gags in
it. Though the fucking valet thing was the dumbest thing to me.
I thought it was funny, but yeah, like, she would get caught very quickly.
Yeah, like, first the place they go that has valet parking is they're driving through a parking lot to get to the valet. Like, what? This isn't a place that looks like it should have valet parking anyway. You don't drive through the parking lot usually to get to a valet to go park your car.
Yeah.
That's not how that's usually work. And then it's just like, she takes the car and is like, oh, I need to joyride in this car.
Well, like, what? You would notice that the mileage went up or that the gas was lower afterwards.
Yeah.
Especially when he was so touchy about it with her. Like, immediately, he's just like, hey, don't get any scratches on it. You know it's someone who's touchy about their car and pays attention to all these things.
Mm-hmm.
But... She did the joyride in there. And then apparently she didn't have any other cars to attend to. Like,
yeah,
she was
like
driving
she's
for forever
still working.
And like
and she's like she's all rushing back when Sam and Dean are done their dinner or whatever, and it's just like I've never seen a valet that's like, this is your one car, deal with that. Once you go park that one, you're done, I guess.
Yeah, unless it was like a super short joyride.
Yeah. So, like, she's still on duty, though. She would be expected to be there for when the next car came by, you know? It's not like, oh, man, she disappeared. Well, I guess she's taking a really long time to park that car. That's okay.
Yeah. They had, like, a lot of opportunity for character moments where they just have conversations with Sam and Dean, which was nice. I mean, like, other than, like, secrets, they don't, you know, those are...
Yeah, they seemed a little more human in this one, so it was better.
They had the bit where Sam was talking to Dean about commitments, like if they want to like commit to a relationship with someone, and then he's like, you know, oh, don't you ever want more than just a one night stand? Because they seem to have forgotten like Lisa and Ben existed, or the dog that Sam left him for, like all that stuff. It's like, but you kind of already covered this ground.
Yeah, it's a little silly.
Yeah, don't you ever want more? Yeah, we had to wipe their minds. You remember that?
Well, it's a sign the show's going too long if you can't remember that you've been there.
Yeah, like, if they'd phrased it differently, it would have been better. Like, not acting
they
like
could
that
have
didn't
brought them
exist.
up even, to make to enhance the point.
Yeah, Dean could have even said, like, he's like, I tried that before, you know how that turned out, you know.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah, it feels dumb to bring up something like that when it has happened and act like it hasn't.
I thought it was interesting when they were, they had the conversation about his dream about their dad. And Dean brings up that he dreams about their dad all the time, too. Like, he has the same dream over and over that's sort of this comfort to him. And then Sam mentions that he dreams about their mom and about a normal life, which is interesting since he never really got to know her until after she was dead, since she died when he was a baby. And it was nice to bring up that family element again, because even though it is about the brothers all the time, you know, it did used to be about like their dad and their mom and all these things about their family. And it's nice when that's brought up every once in a while. But yeah, I thought there was like some good gags in that. Like, there's a lot of good physical gags in the car thing. They found interesting ways to shoot around the car without making it static all the time.
I like kind of like the part where Castiel's on the phone and he's fighting the thing.
Well, that is because that's apparently how they're gonna write Castiel out for a while. He's just watching Netflix. Instead of like having him off doing
me
some
more
angel
in the
thing.
Second one, because he at least cameoed on the phone in this one, but yeah.
I guess that's sort of the segue into the other one I'll have, since I think we covered most of what was going on in the car one. But yeah, Castiel.
Well, we didn't really talk about what they were. They were fighting these ghoul pyres.
Ghoul pyres, yeah.
I did like when was it? He called them were pyres first, and then waited for Sam to like the joke, and he doesn't. He kind of had a funny face about that.
The writing with them seemed to be a little bit more like older stuff used to be. Like, they have some humor, but it doesn't feel like it went too backwards with things, which was nice.
Yeah, I did really like, too, when he decapitates the one ghoul pyre and his head lands on the windshield.
Oh, yeah.
He turns the wipers on to knock it off.
Yeah, that was good.
But then there's silly things like them driving around with blood all over the window of the car, and Sam's shooting a gun in the middle of town, and it's just like, okay, what? No one's alarmed by any of this. Oh, there's a car with blood all over the side.
Yeah,
of it.
They're driving through town, all over the place. With blood on the windshield, no one notices this giant blood splatter with a handprint in it.
Yeah.
Sam was shooting a gun in the street, and also Dean, after he decapitated him, was shooting him, and he was there for a long time. Just all of these things that, like, would normally people would notice, like crashing into the construction. Where were the people that were supposedly working there? They had the car there, or the machinery, so it's not like the workers had to have been that far off.
They just looked over, saw him decapitating the deputy and shoving coins in his mouth, like, oh well.
Lots of unrealistic things going on there.
Yeah, but still overall pretty good.
Yeah, I actually liked it all right. That was one that I wouldn't mind rewatching, actually, which is very rare in these latest seasons. So I was surprised I liked that one all right.
And then dumb again.
And then dumb again, yes. So the Castiel side plot, instead of going off doing some angel thing, it's just him sitting at the bunker watching Netflix. That's what they've decided to go
with.
Yeah,
they say he's watching The Wire.
He's watching The Wire.
I'm so glad Castiel's a main character so that he can not go with Sam and Dean most of the time. Like,
I get
so sick of this show. Having to stay in the same formula all the time. It's like, no, that's not how it usually goes, though. We don't usually have Castiel with them, so it has to just be Sam and Dean going.
Well, that was part of why I liked the car one, was because it changed the formula a little bit, even if it's just how they filmed it. Like, at least it did change something, even though the story itself is fairly standard. But the way that they went about it was an interesting and different way.
Yeah.
I mean, it would have been nice if Castiel was actually there, but
the
at least they had the
phone
thing. The
creatures were decent in that one, too. At least there's something different. because there's been a lack of a lot of different things on the show, too.
Yeah, it was at least a different sort of thing. And it did continue the plot without it being like everything has to go back to the overarching thing. Like, it did mention it, but it wasn't like it took over parts of it. It was just like the monsters are creating armies to fight the darkness.
Well, the next one tricks you by making you think it's not a part of that, and then it is.
Like, yeah.
Remember ghosts? Just kidding. There's no ghosts in this one.
Yeah. That one was called Thin Lizzy. I thought when it was starting, I was kind of liking it. Like, I was like, oh, okay, going a little old school with this ghost plot. And then they were like, well, it doesn't seem like it's a ghost. This place is like a hoaxy place. And I'm like, oh, they're doing a little twist on it. Okay. Seem like it's going to be like an old plot, but then do a new twist. And it's like, oh, okay, that'd be interesting. And then it was like, it all falls apart near the end. it all goes down the toilet. Ash was very scared. My cat just went running. She was like, I don't want to talk about Thin Lizzy. Get out of here. But anyway, so they think that these murders are going on at the Lizzie Borden bed and breakfast / museum, which is at Lizzie Borden's actual house, I guess, and it's a tourist trap. Anyway, they think it's Lizzie Borden's ghost that's hacking people up, and it turns out that it's actually involved with Amara and people who've lost their souls, which is where it goes into the inconsistent and strange.
She sucks the soul from this one guy who still seems to have a lot of emotion for someone who's soulless.
Yeah. Well, like
it's really odd compared to how they've shown a soulless person before.
Yeah.
Like, he says he's faking, but you never see at one point where it really seems like he doesn't have his soul.
Well, if he was faking it, that if they're going to go with, oh, he really doesn't feel anything, but then he's faking it because he remembers what it used to be like, well, they can't act like he's very concerned about how he's feeling, because he wouldn't be feeling anything because he doesn't have a soul. Yeah. But he's desperate and concerned, and those are feelings.
Yeah, and even the will, or the desire to act like it was before, you know, that's feelings, you know.
Yeah, because even like when Sam was soulless, he was acting like a robot, but he was also acting like a hunter, because I guess that's just what he did.
Oh, yeah, he did that because old Grandpa Campbell was around and got him to do it.
Yeah,
because
he was the one making him do it. And then when he was with Dean, like, Dean was the one making him do it or whatever. So at least there were like motivating factors there, but not with this guy. He just did it because I don't know. And, like, he acted worried after he killed the girl, and it was like, all right, but why would
he was worried when Dean came to question him, too. Now he's being stammery and stuff. Like,
yeah.
It's not the very soulless or whatever.
Yeah, and they're acting like people are different when they're soulless, depending on who they are. So some of them are kind of psycho killers, and then some of them aren't. And it's like, well, but why? Does it take away your inhibitions, or just you just don't feel anything? Because I could get, like, if they accidentally killed someone, they wouldn't care, or something like that. It's like, okay, because they're soulless, they don't really care if someone dies, whatever. But then they're actively going out there like, ah, ha, ha, I always wanted to kill someone. But that's a desire. That's like, that's a want. And then they can't say that they don't have wants.
I like that Crowley just lost control of Amora in this one, I guess, and she just went off on her own. Like, I'm gonna go to the Lizzie Borden Museum. Oh, no doubt. Oh, she's gone. She kept eating her babysitters anyway. I can't do anything with her.
You were being bad, Amora. You're grounded.
I'm hangry. Oh, shit.
She hasn't done anything that's scary either.
No, she just does the same thing. Oh, sucks souls. I guess when she gets to final evolution form, she's going to now do hyper beam, blow stuff up.
Whatever.
She's gonna get together with Dean, and because she's after Dean because they shared that moment in the darkness together, because she is the darkness. But they were in the darkness. And they darknessed it up, and she's gonna darkness it.
Just, you know, they're talking this whole episode about how, like, being soulless is is hollow and you don't feel anything and like you want to feel what you used to feel, the things that you used to like. That's what the show makes us feel like. The show, it's like this is hollow and doesn't mean anything. I want it to, I know I used to enjoy it. I want it to feel like that again, but it's just meaningless, utterly meaningless. Anything could happen. And I'm like, it happened. Like they
It
have the
just,
whole
it's a
thing.
shell of a show.
Yeah, like they had the whole thing with Castiel being under that spell, and then he's going into like seizures or whatever, and it's all this intense, like, oh no, what's going on? I'm sitting there the whole time, like, I guess this is going on. What time is it?
You're not worried about anything.
No, it
There's
doesn't
like
mean
that
anything.
point too where it's like Dean gets attacked. I'm like, oh, I guess Dean's dead.
Yeah,
Like, who cares?
it's so violent now. None of the violence means anything. Like you're used to them just getting the shit beat out of them, but it doesn't really matter. The only time, like, it kind of worked in the car one, the gags of the violence, you know, like them driving around covered in blood and stuff like that. That was kind of funny, but it was because it was sort of like a humorous take on it. Like, but most of the time when it's just like violent and dark, it's like, well, I guess that's just a Wednesday afternoon.
And you know the main ones aren't gonna die, which there aren't that many of, but you know they're all safe. And then you're surprised if someone else does live, but it's like, oh, if they live, they're gonna come back in another episode and die,
Yeah.
so.
Well, even if they died, it wouldn't matter anyway. Death doesn't mean anything. Oh, except they can die for realsies now. That Reaper told them they're not going to save them this time. As if that makes it more intense or something.
Oh, well, you
Da-da-da-da.
know what? If they died, still something would go find their souls and bring it back
Oh,
anyway.
yeah. And then they'd be like, we're renewed for another season. And fuck off.
Found their souls in the
Can you
abyss.
guys please just be canceled already? Please.
I was so bored too when that girl was talking about Amora, the one she turned into a killer.
Oh yeah, and she's like,
She just
oh, it
kept
was like,
talking, and it's like, I don't care.
well, she fell into the typical supernatural villain speech about what they did for no reason, where you just sort of tune out, where they're just like, we gotta find out what happened, so we're not gonna write it in any like natural way. We're just gonna have like Sam and Dean question them, and then they tell them because they're like, "Oh, I'm gonna kill you anyway, so let me do my speech." It was almost interesting, almost, because when they had the flashback to like the girl, and then she meets Amara, and then she's sort of like, she was abused, and then she kind of feels for her, like she thinks that Amara is some neglected girl, and she's like, "I'm gonna help you out." And I thought maybe there was sort of this thing where it's like, they had sort of this connection there, and like there was a human who was being kind to her for no reason other than to be kind, you know. And then Amara learning about people, something like that. But then no, it was just like 2 seconds. They're like, "Oh, you must be an angel. I'm not an angel. Suck your soul out." All right. That if they'd built that up a little more, like maybe she became friends with her and she didn't suck her soul, and she was learning about, you know, like the kind side to humans rather than just like murderers or demons or whatever, like someone being kind to her. But then something happens where she eventually sucks her soul out, and kind of like there's that sucker punch, like she kind of loses faith in humanity, and that's what so turns it more toward darkness, the darkness, something like that. Because it could be like she's older than, you know, heaven and hell or whatever, so it's like, well, what if she doesn't know the difference between good or evil? She just knows what she's learning as she goes. Could have been something like that, and then like they built it up a little bit and made it mean something more when she killed someone who was kind to her, something like that. But they didn't. She just did like a speechy speech and then gets killed. It went on just short of forever. And it drew out the ending of the episode a lot too. Like it was like the structure was going okay, and then all of a sudden it was like dedicate like a third of the episode to just like blah 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 blah. This is what happened, what I did, blah 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 blah.
Then other soulless guy kills her, and it's like, well, I'm gonna turn myself in. It's
It
like,
makes it
okay,
easy.
so you're gonna kill people in jail, I guess. Oh well. That takes care of him. Let's have some burgers and then play triumphant music for no reason. So out of place. Like, what?
Because it wasn't like it was a particularly triumphant ending. It was like, oh, that
No.
guy's kind of
It almost
screwed.
sounded like comedic, is like
Yeah, it
almost
was
the
comedic.
comedy music sting.
That's the kind of music that they play after they say a particularly funny line and then end it. You know, like, it's just the wrap up.
Yeah. It's like nothing funny happened. All right.
They might as well have played like the Seinfeld commercial sting. All right. Why did they do that? Because it was funny that they ate burgers.
Who gives a fuck about this episode? Burgers. And then Amora saw the burger and sucked its soul out.
So yeah, what would you say is what your final thoughts on these episodes here?
Dumb, good, dumb.
Yeah, pretty much. Bad Seed was the worst because it was just focusing on the arc and it was terrible. Baby was good because it just sort of changed the formula a little bit. Thin Lizzy started out fine, like it was average, and then it just downhill. Didn't give a crap.
We were more excited when we thought it was about ghosts again. And then it's like, just kidding.
Yeah, I was like, what? It's about a ghost and it's not about like angels or demons or darkness or anything? Okay.
No.
Oh, I wanted to mention the whole thing about like apparently Sam has a serial killer fetish now.
Yeah, what?
When did that happen?
Yeah,
they
that was
they
one
already
thing
fought.
about that.
Yeah, they already fought the ghost of a serial killer too. It's not like that's even a new thing. Remember they had the murder house, I forget the guy's name, but he was a real serial killer, and then that was with Joe way back in like season 2 or 3 or something. And they were kidnapped in the house, like maybe it was a hotel, I don't know. It was like converted to have all these like traps in it, and the ghost of the serial killer was in it. That was a good episode. I like that one. But that's because it was an earlier one. Anyway, that was weird that Sam had a serial killer fetish that's never been mentioned before since. I don't really understand that.
He's really into death because he doesn't see enough on this show, apparently.
It seems like such an un-Sam thing, doesn't it? Like, oh, serial killer fetish. It's like, what?
Right.
Okay. I don't understand.
Stupid.
Yeah. So for those of you guys listening who have not been watching Supernatural, you might want to check out Baby. It's interesting and very light on the overarching plot. So if you want to see something that's going on but not watch stupid Crowley and Rowena, whatever, I'd recommend that one. But the other ones just skip out on.
I'm already sick of Rowena again.
Yeah, we got like one episode with her. It's like, oh, can you not? Can you please just leave? Overstayed your welcome. And they're talking about fucking Megatron again. They're like, let's find him. And I'm like, why? Whoever asked for him back? Absolutely no one did. No one wants Booger to come back. It's just another annoying element.
Fucking Megatron.
Just stop.
It's like Castiel do something at the very least. Fuck.
Yeah.
Like he doesn't, and not just with Megatron. He can do something when it does not involve angels.
Yeah, that would
Holy
make it
fuck
interesting.
Show. No, he can only show up when there's some angel creep or some Crowley crap. Better get your witch bullets. It's gonna be a long season of crap.
I got two words for this. Suck sandwich.
Sandwich bullets.